Thanks to CodeMotion and Deep Learning Italia for inviting me to this conference. I am Luca Pedarelli. I work in Bordeaux at INRIA as postdoctoral researcher. Previously, I worked in the Department of Computer Science at the University of Pisa, where I did the PhD in Computer Science. My research area concerns the analysis and the development of deep neural networks in the field of machine learning, time series, and sequence modeling. In particular, within my PhD thesis, I introduced a novel class of deep and recurrent neural networks called deep exhaustive networks. We combined aspects from randomized neural network, deep learning, and recurrent neural networks. With the deep exhaustive network, it's possible to analyze the intrinsic role of layering in deep recurrent architectures, and at the same time, to develop efficient solutions for deep recurrent models. A sequence is a set of elements with sequential dependencies. For instance, a time series is a set of elements with causal dependencies between observations. Typically, time series are characterized by multiple timescale dynamics. Then, if we aim to solve a time series task, we need a model able to represent multiple time frequency components. There are a lot of fields in which we need to solve time series and sequences task. For instance, in speech recognition, the input audio is a time series. Or more in general, a text is a sequence of elements with complex dependencies. In medicine, time series are very important to make diagnosis with medical data or to make prediction. For instance, in the case of COVID-19, we need to predict the epidemic curve. A typical task is next step prediction. For instance, at the left bottom, we have a time series composed by sum of frequencies. Given the observation at time step t, we must predict the observation at time step t plus 1. Another example is shown in the bottom right figure, in which the text is represented as a sequence of elements. And we have to estimate the sentiment, positive or negative. Statistically, a time series is a sequence of random variables. Each random variable is described by a density function. For instance, the Gaussian distribution represented in the left of the figure, or the uniform distribution represented in the right figure. For each random variable, we can define the mean, the variance, and the standard deviation or the covariance. These measures are very useful for the temporal analysis of the data and for understand the characteristics of the time series. Deep neural networks are machine learning models characterized by layers of neurons. The input layer is fed by an input vector. The hidden layers compute nonlinear transformations that allow the model to enrich the internal representation of the input. And the output layer performs a regression or a classification task in the case of supervised machine learning. These models are typically trained end-to-end with gradient descent and backpropagation. The difference between deep and shallow models, it is not formally defined. In general, a deep model is composed by many hidden layers, while a shallow model is composed by a single layer. An open research issue is to understand what is the role of layers and how the layers allow the model to improve the prediction ability. A first example of the ability of layers in improving the internal representation in order to solve a task is shown in the perceptron. Perceptron is one of the first models for neural networks. It is composed by a layer of neurons that computes the output. The computation is very simple because we have an input vector x multiplied by the weights w. The weights are trained to solve a particular task with the delta rule approach. The perceptron can easily solve linearly separable tasks like a Boolean function such as AND OR. Like in this example, but it cannot solve a non-linearly separable problem. In this case, the solution is to add a layer in a proper way, and this layer allows the model to transform the problem in a more abstract representation that is linearly separable. This is an intuition of why the layers improve the training in deep neural networks because since layer transformation adds dimension in the internal representation, the problem tends to be more simple and more linearly separable in the last layers. Then, why should we need more layers? Empirically, deep neural networks obtain the state-of-the-art results in a real-world application, such as computer vision, neural language processing, mastering the complex games, chess, shogi, and go. They typically obtain a better performance with respect to shallow models. They approximate better the continuous functions with respect to shallow model, and they are suitable for GPU parallelization. Anyway, we have some open issues in the deep learning field. It is not formally defined what makes deep learning deep, what means deep mathematically, how is information represented, why deep learning models achieve good performance, how many layers and how many neurons we need to have a good representation. Why should we use deep neural networks for time series? How a deep neural network develops the temporal features inside the layers? And why does a recurrent neural network for sequence modeling achieves better results by using four, five layers with respect to use a one-layered recurrent neural network? In the field of computer vision, we can qualitatively analyze the internal representation of a deep model. This architecture represents the typical convolutional neural network used for image classifications, and we can analyze the internal representation of a CNN just looking at the trained weights. And we can see that the first layer is focused on the details, such as points and borders. And the second layers is focused on more general concept, and in general the representation is progressively more abstract with the increasing of the layers number. In this case, we have images, and then we can easily interpret the kind of representation, but in the case of time series or sequences such as text or speech, how can we study the temporal representation? This is a simple recurrent neural network, which is a neural network suitable for time series processing and sequence modeling. It is characterized by feedback connections, which implement a memory mechanism. The memory is represented by the state variable x in the formula. And we can see that x at time step t depend on the input at time step t and on the state at time step t minus 1. These networks are typically trained end-to-end with the algorithm backpropagation throughout time. This is the unfolded structure of a recurrent neural network over time. An RNN is a discrete dynamical time system. The recurrent weights are represented by a matrix W at W. And the norm of this matrix controls the dynamics of the system. If the matrix has small values, then the signal converges rapidly from the input to the output. In this case, the recurrent neural network is stable, which is good for a machine learning algorithm in general. But you have short temporal dependencies. Then you have a bad memory. If you have a matrix with big values, then the recurrent neural network improves the long-term dependencies, but the system could be chaotic, which is very bad for machine learning from a machine learning point of view. In the case of learning, the problem is known as vanishing or exploding gradients. There are two ways to address this problem. The first is the ecosystem networks. Ecosystem networks avoid the learning problem by fixing the recurrent weights with a proper norm to control the dynamics. And the gated recurrent neural network implement an adaptive gate, which learn to control the dynamic inside the detector. The most famous gated model is the long short-term memory, LSTM. In this talk, we focus on ecosystem networks that allows us to study the intrinsic characteristic of the dynamic of the dynamic neural network without considering the learning algorithm. An ecosystem network is a recurrent neural network implemented within the reservoir computing framework. It is composed by a recurrent layer called reservoir, and it is randomly initialized and left untrained. If we aim to solve a task, we can train the output layer just by using a simple regular regression and avoiding the backpropagation algorithm. Ecosystem network is much more efficient than LSTM or other fully trained neural network because we avoid to train the recurrent layer for each time step of the input time series. It achieves better results with respect to LSTM in time series prediction characterized by noisy and continuous data. In order to study the characteristics of deep neural network for time series within my thesis, we introduced deep ecosystem networks. They are composed by a hierarchy of recurrent layers randomly initialized. The output is computed starting from all the layer states in order to exploit all the internal representation developed by the layers. From these studies, it turned out that the effect of the input perturbation lasts long in higher layers. Timescale dynamics are ordered according to the depth of the layers, and timescale dynamics are progressively slower in the deeper layer. Moreover, in the layer, we can see a diversified frequency components, and the ability is of the network is to develop multiple frequency representation ordered among the architecture's hierarchy. Higher layers are focused on lower frequency components. Overall, deep neural networks are able to develop hierarchical and distributed temporal features. And this ability is intrinsic in the deep recurrent architectures without the use of backpropagation. Moreover, you can see a deep recurrent neural network as a constrained version of a shallow recurrent neural network. This sparsity of weights allows the deeper NN to be more efficient than one-layered RNN. For these reasons that we see in the previous slides, in recent years The most of applications use the combination of two approaches: layering, more layers, and recurrent neural network with gates. This is another work in which we compared deep ecosystem network with typical recurrent neural network used in deep learning applications. This is a typical task to compare gated recurrent neural networks. It is a multivariate prediction on musical compositions. We can see that deep ecosystem networks often perform better than fully trained recurrent neural networks, and moreover, they are extremely efficient, as you can see from the training time in the table. Thank you for your attention.
Let me check the Discord channel. Okay, the first question. During your speech, you mentioned the deep ecostate network. You say this model doesn't use the backpropagation for training. Could you explain much better this part? Because I think it's an important part.
Okay, this is in the field of reservoir computing. Reservoir computing is a general paradigm in which the recurrent part of the neural network is randomly initialized and left untrained, because in this way you can control the dynamic of the processing of the recurrent neural network. By controlling the spectral properties of the recurrent matrix, because the recurrent matrix in a recurrent neural network is very important, because the recurrent matrix represents the memory of the network, no? Allows the network to encode a time series, the whole time series, in the state of the network. And the recurrent matrix, the spectral properties of the recurrent matrix controls the dynamic of the dynamic system of the recurrent neural network. In this way, you can control the memory and how much memory take into account in the network, and at the same time, you can control the stability of the dynamic system. And in particular, with the deep ecostate network, you have a stack of recurrent layers, and each recurrent layer work on a different dynamic. And in this way, the deep recurrent architecture is able to develop a multiple time-scale representation. And this is very good when you need a rich representation to perform, for instance, the prediction, a time series prediction, or a time series classification. And
Okay.
then by avoiding the backpropagation, you can control the dynamics. And the only part of the network that is trained is the output layer.
Okay,
And this is
so the last layer.
the last layer, and this is the last layer. Typically, is linear. Then the training is very simple, because just to solve a least mean square problem, a regression to solve the task. Then it is also characterized by
Okay,
extreme efficiency.
we have two questions, but we have 2 minutes. So just the first one from Marco. When it comes to time series modeling with machine learning, transformer neural network are hot now. Okay, this is okay. The first part. Did you compare deep ecostate network with transformer network? Also, do deep ecostate have the same level of parallelism of transformers? This is a very good question.
Yes. This is an interesting question, because for the moment we compared the deep ecostate network with long short-term memory and gated recurrent units, that are the main recurrent neural network used for sequence modeling. And transformer is typically used in natural language processing, because typically the text is the dependencies between words are not causal, no? Then you need a mechanism like the attention mechanism implemented in the transformers to build complex dependencies between words, for example. And while in the case of time series, in which you have a signal that is continuous and noisy, is for my experience is much more better to use acoustic network, because you can control the dynamical system, and you can in this way, in a natural way, you can control also the causality, because in time series typically the dependencies between elements are causal. And then it is a possible future work to compare transformer, to use the transformer in the case of time series. It is very, very, very interesting aspect.
Sorry.
And this was to finish. No, because the second, the point of parallelization is that depend by the kind of data, because if you have a time series, if you have to address all the time series, you can't parallelize the process.
Okay, Luca, we have other questions. Maybe you can join to the Discord channel and answer the question from the audience. Yeah. So thank you, Luca, again for your presentation. Please join to the Discord channel to answer the question from the attendee. Thank you, Luca.
Okay, thank you.